That's where you go with that. Don't let nobody make you feel uncomfortable. But it's, you know, right now, for real, that's real. You know, right now it's hot, you know. It's a hard time for fat folks. It's the worst. Summertime is the worst for fat people. We don't know how to dress. We don't know what to put on. Fat people want to be cool, too. We can't walk around without our damn shirt on. You can't do it. All that flab hanging, kids swinging from your titty meat. You gotta put on, and I feel sorry for big women. Big women, y'all wanna take them bras off. You got them two basketballs hanging down. They all in your belt waist and shit. Your titty nipple prints all over your waist and shit. Now I got like you got three tiers of stomach and shit. Look like you hiding the motherfucker in there, man. Could you come in for a minute? You can't bring all those kids into Six Flags. It's rough on fat folks now, because this is when everybody had their backyard barbecues. It's hot, everybody cooking, everybody want to invite you over for backyard barbecues, you know, and all, you know, but I'm going to tell you something. You know, most times, plastic chairs are not fat people's friends. I'm going to tell you that right now. We don't like them, and they don't like us, all right? Plastic chairs are not fat people's friends, I swear. And every time I go over friends out, they got a backyard barbecue. They always got them damn plastic chairs. Ain't got one steel chair nowhere. My boy gonna come in and say, boy, you better get over here, man. I just put a spread together. Boy, you better come over and get something to eat, boy. He offended me because he act like I ain't had no damn food. I got food. I'm like, I got food in my house. Food, you ain't did shit. He like, what, you ain't coming over? I said, I'm at the door. Yeah. Shit, I was ready to grub. I looked over there, all these young bitches having these plastic chairs. I said, I thought this motherfucker was my friend. He ain't my friend. All he got these damn plastic chairs. He said, well, man, make your plate sit on down. I said, I'm gonna make a plate. But I ain't sitting down. He said, what, you too good to break bread from me and my family? I said, I love you and your family. I don't mind breaking bread with your family. I just don't want to break your chair. That's all I don't want to do. So my man, please, that chair holds you. You gonna fix your plate, sit down. I said, man, I know that chair holds me. Plastic chairs ain't fat people's friend. I know they ain't. I said, man, them good chairs. I got them from Lowe's. Like that make a damn different life. Lowe's got stronger fucking plastic chairs than Home Depot. He got real upset. Man, you better sit your ass down and eat some food. I said, fuck it, you my boy. I'm going to fix me a plate. So I went on and made my plate, but I put it in little sections in the plate so it looked like I was eating a lot. You know, that plate with all the compartments. So all my food was separated so I could enjoy every taste. I went on and sat down, but I ain't put all my hunches on that plastic chair. I was leaning forward like I was in the conversation. I was leaning forward like that. I was like, what? You crazy, dog. You wild. And I noticed while I was eating my food, I was noticing that the chair wasn't buckling or moving. I was like, well, maybe these chairs from Lowe's might be stronger than the chairs from Home Depot. And I really wanted to enjoy the potato salad, because whoever made a potato salad must have been blessed by God, you know what I'm saying? Because they had boiled the potatoes to perfection, where they was almost to the point where you could whip them some bits, but they diced them all the way down with little dicing pieces and shit. They chopped up the onions and diced them, the green peppers and celery and that son of a bitch, you understand what I'm saying? Oh, it was looking good, boy. And then they put a little dash of mustard in there. But they put clumps of Miracle Whip in that bitch. You understand me? Woo! Miracle salad ain't the potato salad ain't shit without no Miracle Whip. And they stirred that motherfucker up, and I knew it was good because they put a dash of paprika on top of that son of a bitch. This one I knew it was delicious, you know, because they did a day of them sliced devil eggs all around it for garnish. I said, ooh, wee! Fuck them cakes, fuck them pies. This is my dessert. I wanted to enjoy that potato salad, so I went on through the rest of them hunnids on that chair so I could enjoy this potato salad. But soon as I stuck my fork in that damn potato salad, it was like the chair woke up and went, hell no. Squatted down, ejected my ass in the grass. My potato salad flew over there with their dog. That dog was over there fucking my potato salad up. But he had a nerve to look at me and say, man, this is good motherfucking potato salad. I said, I know, nigga, I know. And then the cheer turned back into a cheer like a transformer, like it didn't have shit to do with the situation. Everybody came out like they ain't know that. Like, what happened? What happened? You know what the fuck happened. Your damn cheer from Lowe's just threw me in the fucking grass. Now your dog eating my damn potato salad. Then that grandma, you know, old folks don't got no filter. She came out. He should have checked the capacity. He should have checked the capacity. The capacity on the bottom of the chair and says 150. He should have put five chairs together. Yeah, fuck you, old lady. I'm gonna punch you in your chest. You run the one to make this potato salad. Yeah, it's summertime, it's that barbecue time. But everybody think they can barbecue, and everybody can't barbecue. I don't give a shit. My uncle gonna bring over some. Yeah, I went on a queue this morning. He brought over this meat. This meat was blacker than Ving Rams and Wesley Snipes, and it was there, was all rolled up together. It looked like he should have pulled off at the motherfucking burnt ward and dropped that shit off. It need, that meal needed a Black Lives Matter fucking shirt on. I said, nigga, ain't nobody eating that burnt up shit. I said, kid, it's just Cajun. I said, well, shit, I'm a nigga. I ain't no Cajun. I ain't eating that bullshit. I'm gonna eat that. You mean, I hope you season it with Rolaids. Because you're gonna have an ass trying to eat that bullshit. I said, you can put that away. Ain't nobody eating that bullshit. You know, that's how it is. Some people, you don't cook with the fire, you cook with the smoke. That's what you gotta understand. Some people don't understand that. And everything ain't a damn grill. Just because you got some cinder blocks and a grate on top of it don't mean it's a fucking grill. That's a campfire, motherfucker. That's all that is. You cook meat on there at your own damn risk. My little young cousin, he had good intentions, you know. He tried to barbecue, he bought the meat, but he couldn't bought for charcoal, so he cut the grass and used all the clippings as charcoal. He come burn up the clippings in there, motherfucker, had ragweed and crabgrass and shit, and a little poison ivy. Niggas had hay fever, and my lips was itchy for 2 weeks. I'm sitting there with calamine lotion all around my mouth. Looked like I had a boyfriend. Yeah.